This conference will now be recorded.
Hello everyone. My name is Arushi Grover. I'm working as an assistant professor in Institute of Information Technology and Management, Janakpuri. Students, the topic that I'm going to discuss today is a part of the paper called ED, that is Entrepreneurship Development. This subject is a part of the curriculum of BCom and BBA courses. The topics for today are basics of entrepreneurship, which includes concept of entrepreneurship, traits of an entrepreneur, and types of entrepreneurs. Let's understand the meaning of this term, that is an entrepreneur. The word entrepreneur is derived from the French verb entreprendre, which means to undertake. This refers to those who undertook the risk of new enterprises. There are different definitions given. Let's study them, understand them. According to Joseph Schumpeter, entrepreneurs are innovators who use the process of shattering the status quo of the existing products and services to set new products, new services. He describes entrepreneurs as innovators. Joseph Schumpeter gave theory of innovation, wherein Schumpeter linked the two terms, that is innovation and an entrepreneur. Entrepreneur as an innovator means someone who makes a shift from the existing pattern, product or service and introduces new product, new service, new technology and new combinations or patterns. Another definition given by J.B. Say, it explains an entrepreneur is the coordinator and organizer of resources to design a business enterprise. J.B. Say defined another important trait of an entrepreneur, that is the coordinator and organizer of resources, someone who gathers and assembles all the factors of production like land, labor, capital. Now further, let's understand the meaning of entrepreneurship. What is entrepreneurship? The process includes initiating a business venture, organizing the necessary resources, coordinating them, assembling them, and then assuming the associated financial, psychological, and social risks and rewards. So understanding each and every dynamic. Then the characteristics of an entrepreneur could be brave, innovative, independent, risk taker, achievement oriented, all of them. Now through this diagram, let's understand the essence of this term. Entrepreneur is a person who creates an enterprise, that is the objective or purpose of an entrepreneur is to establish an enterprise. Now this process of creation, process of action, all the activities that an entrepreneur undertakes to establish an enterprise is a process. This process is called entrepreneurship. Now the next topic is traits of an entrepreneur. The traits of an entrepreneur includes vision, having that foresightedness as to what needs to be achieved, what is the goal, what is the target. Then sticking at it. Then passion. Passion is one of the traits of an entrepreneur because an entrepreneur needs to be passionate about what he is doing, what he wants to do, and what he wants to pursue. An entrepreneur also is an uncertainty tolerant, someone who has this tolerance to unpredictable environment, someone who is flexible towards it. An entrepreneur also has self-confidence, has adaptability, is adaptable and flexible to the changes happening in the dynamic environment, dynamic business environment. Rule breaking, establishing rules that are relevant, that are required to be followed. An entrepreneur has the ability to plan and execute it further. Somebody who is involved in his work. An entrepreneur is self-motivated, self-reliant. These are certain traits of an entrepreneur. Let's understand another topic, that is the types of entrepreneurs. Different types of entrepreneurs have been classified under different bases, that is first on the basis of type of business, Next is on the basis of use of technology, based on ownership, based on gender, based on the size of an enterprise, based on stages of development, and very important, based on functional characteristics given by Clarence Danhof. Let's understand these classifications in detail. First is based on the type of business. This includes three types of an entrepreneur. First is trading, second manufacturing entrepreneur, and third is agricultural entrepreneur. Now, trading entrepreneurs are those entrepreneurs who procure the finished and final products from the manufacturers or the people who have produce those products and sell these to the customers directly or through a retailer. They serve as the middleman, somebody who is a wholesaler, dealer, retailer. So they act as the link between the manufacturers and the customers. Now, next is manufacturing entrepreneurs. People who are involved in the production side of it. They identify the needs of the customers in the market. They explore the resources which would be required to manufacture the product, technology that needs to be used to manufacture the product, and hence to satisfy the needs and wants of the customers, making sure whatever the customer needs and whatever the changing needs of the customers are, their tastes and preferences, that should be satisfied by the products and services that they are manufacturing. Next is agricultural entrepreneur. They undertake agricultural pursuits are people who are called agricultural entrepreneurs. They are involved into wide spectrum of activities which are related to agriculture, that is like cultivation, marketing of agricultural produce, irrigation, mechanization, and technology. Other activities could be raising and marketing of crops, fertilizers, and other allied activities. Another type, another classification is based on ownership, that is private entrepreneur, state entrepreneur, and joint entrepreneurs. A private entrepreneur is one who, as an individual, sets up a business enterprise, somebody who bears the whole risk, somebody who is the sole owner of it, somebody who's taking the full responsibility of the business. State entrepreneur is that entrepreneurship venture, that venture wherein the activities are undertaken and controlled and managed by the state or the government. Next is joint entrepreneurs. When a private entrepreneur and the government jointly runs a business enterprise, joins their hand to run a particular venture to pursue any objective, those entrepreneurs are called joint entrepreneurs. Next type is based on the use of technology. Two types are here. First is technical entrepreneurs and second non-technical entrepreneurs. Technical entrepreneurs are those people who establish and run science and technology based industries. They are people who are involved more into doing side of the process. That means they are more into implementation and execution of the things that have been planned. They are craftsmen types. They are task-oriented people. They make use of science and technology in their enterprises. Next is non-technical entrepreneurs. These people are on the non-technical side of it. They don't really have technical skills, but they are involved into thinking and strategic planning of the venture. They are involved into formulating strategies, marketing and distribution strategies, establishing methods. They know how to make the business survive and thrive in the competitive market. How to attain that competitive edge, they plan certain activities, they plan methods and policies. They are not concerned with technical side, but rather with marketing and promotion of it. Next is based on gender. There are two types, men entrepreneurs. Enterprises that are owned, managed, and controlled by men. These people who manage it are called men entrepreneurs. Then there is women entrepreneurs. Any enterprise in which 51% of are women and or maybe 51% stake or capital is of women in that enterprise. Those entrepreneurs are called women entrepreneurs. Next is based on the size of enterprise. First is small scale entrepreneur, medium scale, second, and third is large scale entrepreneurs. Small scale entrepreneurs are those who has made an investment in plant and machinery, up to rupees 1 crore in the enterprise. Whereas medium scale entrepreneurs are those who have made their investment in plant and machinery above 1 crore but below 5 crores. Then large scale entrepreneurs, the investment made by them are more than 5 crores. Then basis taken on the basis of stages of development. First generation entrepreneurs, people who do not really possess any entrepreneurial background, they start something of their own, they use their own creative and innovative skills and establish an enterprise. Those are first generation entrepreneurs. Second generation entrepreneurs who inherit the family business. They are also called modern entrepreneurs. These second generation entrepreneurs are those people who inherit the family business and it passes on from one generation to another. Then there is classical entrepreneurs. These people basically have an aim to maximize their economic return at a level which is consistent with the survival of their unit. So without any element of growth, they are just concerned with earning as much as they are able to recover the expenses or the cost that has been incurred. These are called classical entrepreneurs. Next, the classification is based on Clarence Danhof. Clarence Danhof in 1949 gave this classification on the basis of his study of the American agriculture. He classified entrepreneurs in the manner that at the initial stages of economic development, people take less initiatives, they are less innovative, there is no innovation drive in them as such, but as economic development proceeds, they become more innovative and enthusiastic. Let's see the classification. Four types have been given under this. First is innovating entrepreneurs, second imitative, and third Fabian, fourth drone. First innovative entrepreneurs are people who introduces new things in the market, tries to serve new market, new target audience, new goods, providing new services, inaugurates new methods of production, or maybe restructuring and reorganizing the whole enterprise completely. These people are risk takers. These people are people who take first mover advantage. They have the required skills, they have the required resources to be innovative and to create. Whereas imitative entrepreneurs are adoptive in nature. They adopt the technology, they adopt the goods, services, methods of production, and everything that has been done by the innovative entrepreneurs. They are successful in adopting the technologies and everything that has been done by these innovative entrepreneurs. Third is Fabian entrepreneurs. They are characterized by very caution and skepticism. They're very skeptical in nature in terms of experimenting. They do not really like to experiment. They do not really like to change unless there is high need of changing. Unless they see the situation wherein their organization might have this tendency to shut down, then only they will try to introduce that change. That too with so much of skepticism. Otherwise, they are okay with the current state that they are in. Now the last type is drone entrepreneurs. These people completely refuse to adopt to any new opportunities, to adopt to any new changes that have been happening in the dynamic business environment. They like to remain at their status quo. They like to remain at their existing position. They do not really like to change themselves or introduce any kind of change in their product or services or their technologies or in their methods. They're very orthodox and rigid in nature. I hope through this presentation, the concepts of entrepreneurship would be clear to everyone. Thank you.